Okay, we left page 14. Page 14, Mr. Bura. Kishinifne basodim. The person has to defecate, do his bodily functions in the field. Imuachori ageder, and there's a fence, a wall. Yiponemiyad. So he should relieve himself immediately. Shouldn't withhold, restrain himself. Ubapiko. What about if you're in an open location? Yisrachit admokum shliucha chaver luros piruo. You should distance yourself from other people, that when you're doing your function, people should not be able to see your genitals. That's the question of modesty. Let's see, Mishnah Baruches. Yiponemiyad, do ein chaveru roes piruo, because he turns towards the wall, and the wall, he's covered by the wall. וכן בחוץ אחורי כוס לבייס, בקוואצ'ות, אף על פי שחבר שומע כל איתושו של מטו. Although a person hears the person relieving himself, איתוש means the passing the gas. אין בכך כלום שהשמוס כל איתוש של מטו אין בו איסם שום צניאוס. That's not a breach of modesty. אלא שחרפו בוש לבני אודם, משנמקבט אין המקבט, you have no choice. I mean, the person is like is in a stall. The person will leave himself. Although the sound's coming, what are you supposed to do? Right? That's just the nature of that kind of facility. Right? But you're enclosed. So therefore, it's not a question of it's not a breach of modesty. It's a question of what? Embarrassment. In a certain way, it's a question of respect for another person also. Right? Person gets old, he's not able to contain himself. He passes air. Can't help himself. But if someone can, it's a disrespect. It's not a disrespect, it's a disrespect to someone else. You know, the Mogan have later, the halacha is that, you know, one time people, like especially in Europe, but Gemara says this, when people, they studied in the base language, people slept there. Young people, they would sleep there. So people slept there, people would be learning, people would be sleeping, people would be passing air. So there was a smell. Are you permitted to learn? Right? Are you permitted to learn? Because the smell has relevance to excrement. So Gemara says that what the Torah violation is only the excrement itself. It's the waste. There's nothing wrong with the smell. But nevertheless, if it's someone else passed gas, you're permitted, another party's permitted to study. But the person himself who passed the gas, he has to wait till that smell dissipates, and only then he's permitted to study. Because on a Torah level, it's nothing. So the other, if somebody else passes the gas, the air, then nobody would ever be able to study. So therefore, if someone else, you could continue studying. But if yourself, because that's something which it's just a question of time before it'll correct itself, therefore, you're permitted to what? You have to wait until it passes, and then you're permitted to study. Okay? No, that's something that's a disrespect. Pass air, a gas, when you're Midlishman Esrei, it's a disrespect. We'll get there. You know, the halacha is you're supposed to step out. First time, let's say, can't contain himself. He doesn't have to do his bodily function. Midlishman Esrei, and you have to pass air, pass gas. You have to step out, dalet amos, from the location you're davening, pass the gas, and you will see there's a tefillah, and then you step back. Because to pass gas, when you're having the audience, it's considered disrespect to Hashem. That's separate. That's a separate. So tefillah is a separate discussion. There was specifically the Shemon Esrei. Yeah. Correct. Okay. Piruo, what is piruo? Piruo doesn't necessarily mean general. Rotsilo migiluyo. It means your flesh is being exposed. The area of your body that's normally covered, you're exposing yourself. Mishim galab sorbim lefonim la'achrov. Bava pi sheroe es gufo v'shmeh kol itusho shelo shori. Even though you see from a distance, you see the person is exposed. But since you're not close up, it's okay. It's not considered a breach of modesty. Lo yeshi b'mehiro. Okay, this is already a health issue. This is a medical issue. Lo yeshi b'mehiro b'chozek. When a person sits down to do his bodily function, you shouldn't sit down quickly and just like with force, because actually it can affect you. V'lo yenos litruk atzmi yosemidai. And a person shouldn't try to, the person is constipated. The person shouldn't push too hard. Shli yinatik shini hakarkashka. This is Gemara. You're going to somehow affect the physically. You shimei karkashto. It's part of the bowel. You're going to affect what's beyond, what's right on top of the anus inside. Somehow you're going to somehow disrupt that, and you'll cause damage to that, which will ultimately have. This is not. I mean, the Gemara also says it's a question of hemorrhoids. Certain things that which cause hemorrhoids, certain types of function, you know, certain type of behavior. Okay, now this is important. Lo yikaneh biyad yamin. One cleans himself. You should not clean yourself with your right hand. Okay, most people, most people don't know this. Why? What? Okay, now you hear it. It's a Gemara. You shouldn't clean yourself with your right hand. Now, with your right hand, you put on your tefillin. So, if you put on your tefillin, it's a disrespect. The hand that you put on your tefillin, you clean yourself. Another reason we'll see is given is because you eat with your right hand. So, you never know. You could have actually, if the hand is not properly washed, it actually it's a question it could be life threatening. So, therefore. If you're righty, we're talking about a person who's a righty. Righty, you don't clean yourself with your right hand. You don't clean yourself. You will see in a moment. Biyajimin. But then it becomes a problem. But then it's inevitable. I mean, you're going to be exposed. There's a difference if you direct contact or if it passed, you know, like if it was second hand, third hand, fourth hand. You never know what a person touches. Right? Okay. Right. Goyim, you know, it's known. You want to know something. You ever see people the way they conduct themselves in the bathroom? People, especially Goyim, they do whatever they do, they walk out without washing their hands. Right? But forget about not using soap, not walking straight out the door. I mean, sometimes you hesitate even touching the doorknob of the room to walk out of there, in terms of what they touched. So it's inevitable. You hold on to a banister, anything. So do you know what's going on? I mean, they have all kinds of studies. What's on a desktop? What's on in the bathroom? What's this? They just read about a week ago on the trays on when you fly an airplane. Those trays, the amount of bacteria that's on that tray. I mean, you should have some kind of, bacterial cleanser to clean that tray. You wouldn't want to eat on that thing. You know, you can become actually paranoid in terms of that's how much disease there's around. No, not your hands. Put it on the tray itself to sanitize it. Biyajimin shekoshe botfilin azuras smoli. Because a person ties his tefillin on his left hand with his right hand. Now, so we use our left hand, but you wrap the tefillin on the what? On the middle finger, if you're writing, correct? On the left hand. So when you clean yourself with your left hand, you should not make sure not to use that middle finger. It's all the fingers but that middle finger. Shekorach labritzua, kosachronim, di'ita yad shkolinyoni osi bismol. He says, what about a person who's a lefty? So everything he does with his left hand, mekanech bismol di'day, shuyimit kol odom. So for him, he uses his right hand. Vimkosi bismol, lushar masav osi b'yamin. What a person writes with his right, there's no question which hand you can change fill on. Is writing the determining factor, or is it the majority of your activities are done with your which hand? Vimkosi bismol, lushar masav osi b'yamin. Okay, we'll see. Because that determines which end you put the fill-in on.
The writing.
Is writing is a primary function.
Is writing primary?
Well, it's a question. We'll see. Okay? But again, the middle finger of the left hand also should not be used. You know, we always say, you know, the fifth chelak of Shulchan Aruch was never printed. Person breaks his arm. He has a cast on his left hand. To say, you know something? Look, if factually he's not able to. So okay, so he uses his right hand. If it's workable, the optimum way to do is the left hand, not use the middle finger. That's the optimum way in terms of being most respectful. I said, what about a person who has to clean his child? Right, person has small children. You have to change your diaper. You have to clean. So what? Oh, do we make this differentiation? You clean the diaper with your left hand, not with your right hand. Right? Or when you clean the house, you clean up a mess. You use your left hand, not your right hand. Definitely not. It's specifically speaking about your own personal function. Do you kaneh becheris? Mishum kshofim lo basab yiveshim. A person should not cleanse himself with a piece of pottery. Mishum kshofim, because of you're susceptible to sorcery, to witchcraft. Lo basab yiveshim. You should not use dry grass, because again it lacerates. If it's dry, it lacerates. Shema kaneh b'dov she'or sholipo. Someone who cleans himself with which is flammable, which burns easily, so it's dry. Shinav tachtonus noshos. This it's what he spoke about before, the karkashta. It actually affects the rectum. What? Sholi means it's sholipo. Or is fire. It's flammable. Lo betzroshe kineach bo chaveru. To use a stone which has some excrement on it, you should not use. They should maybe certainly tachtonius, because ultimately it will cause hemorrhoids. Using a stone which is not totally clean. He says today that the locations the person does bodily functions are not on the field. The whole reason is because you can be susceptible to kishuv. Kishuv has to do with demons. Gemara says demons are really out in the field. It's not in a location which people, and that's what Gemara says. In the bathroom, in the areas, a person would go in there, he could be harmed. He would be harmed. We had earlier, remember, when we spoke about, he quoted Gemara where a man did his bodily functions, and yes, the Malachim says his wife would put her hand through the window to put it on his head. Then he should not, there should be, it would be, because if they're two people, a person is not susceptible to demons. So Ramos says today that we have the outhouses are now in the field, they're in the community. So we're not concerned about using cheres, because sorcery is based on demons. Right? They summon the demons. That's what sorcery has to do. That's witchcraft. Therefore people do use even something which is flammable. Benamazik, because I am a dove, and see the way factually the way people conduct themselves, it's not a problem. No, they would prepare stones, set aside. Yeah, the Gemara says Gemara. There's a whole question of muktzah, stones muktzah.
Right.
So the question is, so the Gemara speaks about personal hygiene, kavod habrius. Does that override muktzah? That overrides muktzah. It overrides muktzah. Yeah. Years ago, toilet paper, in especially public location, you never found toilet paper. So what if years ago, today you don't see it, but years ago when you bought fruit, like pears, it was wrapped in a piece of paper, in tissue paper. Every pear was wrapped in tissue paper. Do you remember that? In Detroit, you don't remember it. No, and any fruit, it was wrapped in tissue, especially pears. Pears, not apples. Pears were. People used to use that to clean themselves. Nothing was wasted, it's not as available. The leaf you have to tear off a tree. Grass was on the ground. No, we're talking about, no, we're not talking Shabbos. Not talking Shabbos. Person's traveling. All of a sudden, what's it? What are we talking about? What should you clean yourself? Grass? Maybe leaf, you're right. Leaf is better. You can imagine an elephant leaf. See those big leaves? Yeah. Cover the whole community. Taking stone out of the ground is a question of, that's
not
a doraisa.
Yes.
And there's no way you could. It has to do with. It has to do. Let's see. You have to do. You have to tear toward the paper.
Yeah.
You should. You do it klachiyat. You tear it klachiyat. Even the klachiyat is also drabanon. Even klachiyat, you have to do it. Right. But because it's a question of kovod abrius, it's personal dignity. You tear the toilet paper. Klachiyat. Normally tear with your right hand, tear with your left hand. If you have a perforation, you shouldn't tear on the perforation. Because perforations, that's nisidoraisa, cutting exact to exact size. Okay? Steve is enlightened today. You become enlightened today. You learned something you never knew before. Okay? Left of 620, hey?